Are you looking to learn about all of the features that are on offer in Camtasia 2022? If you are, this is the video for you. I've been working with Camtasia since 2006. I'm a recommended Camtasia trainer, and I'm going to show you some of the features that I really like, including the latest updates to Camtasia 2022, which I've already started using. So we're going to do things like the highlight, the fact you can change the highlight color, the fact that you can even add a magnifying glass, or you can use a spotlight type of cursor. You can now actually create your own cursor from an image and just create the path on the top of it. You can smooth out the movement, and there are some great tricks you can do with editing and cutting up a video so you've got different cursors working in different parts of the screen. I'm going to show you all of these effects, all the effects that I use when I'm making my videos. I really hope you like the video, and as always, if you do, please like it, please share it, please comment on it. I'd love to know which tricks you like yourself, or which other ones you use that I'm not using. And of course, join me on my YouTube channel. Let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to show you is the most obvious. That's simply adding the cursor effects. And if we just move through this video a little bit, you'll see that the cursor is moving around on the screen. You can see the cursor there moving as I kind of take the users through my website, and you can see the cursor moving along there as well. Now, what we can do very simply is come down to cursor and click on highlight and drag that onto the video. And immediately what that does is it produces a highlighted cursor for me. So it's a much better effect. It's much easier to see the cursor now. But then we've got a lot of control over the properties of that cursor. If you come over to the right-hand side, the first thing that I always do is reduce the opacity to about 60, simply so that when people are looking through the cursor, when they see the cursor, they can still see what is behind. The other thing that you can do is slightly increase the size. So I'll often make it a little bit bigger if I really want to make it clear. Those are the most standard changes that I make. There is one other change that I often make, and that is that I choose another color. Now, I often do that, for example, if there's a lot of yellow on the screen. So simply I use another color for the cursor so that it really stands out against the background. Another thing that you can do is sometimes you might want to match the cursor with another color that's in the website. So I can click here, for example, and just click on there. And now it will choose that color to be the cursor. And sometimes that can be quite an effective trick. Now, this next option is really interesting. I'm just going to come over to here, and through the properties, I'm going to take off the highlight tool so we've got nothing on the cursor again. And coming over again to cursor effects, this time what I'm going to click on is a really interesting one that I must admit I didn't investigate before, and I never realized how useful this is. Let me just drag this onto the screen and show you what it does. What it does is it highlights exactly what it's rolling over. Now, when you're doing what I'm doing here, this can be really effective because it goes right through and it highlights. Okay, now what you can do, this is really a great trick. Let's say that you don't want to use that cursor all the time because it's not ideal for everything, but it's just ideal in that particular part. Let me show you what you could do. I'm going to turn this off, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the playhead back to when it just starts to go through the menu, okay? Look, when it does that. So I'm gonna play it about here. I'm gonna cut the video at that point. Okay, so I select the video and cut it. Now, moving along, okay, just to that point there. Okay, let's actually, now let's keep it on the screen. Let's do right along to there. Now we want to get rid of it about there. So when it now at that point, and I'll just move it back just a little bit, just to kind of right at that point. Now I'm also going to cut the video. Now why am I doing that? So what I'm going to do now in that, just in that section of the video, is I'm going to drag the magnifying cursor onto the screen. On this section of the video, I'm going to put the highlight tool, as I always do, and also on this section here. So I've actually got now a change in cursor, and I can do that by cutting the video. So let's just quickly play a little bit of that so that you can see that in action.
can also visit any of the sections here along the top. For example, if you want Moodle, just click on Moodle and you'll find loads of videos on working with Moodle. If you come back to the home page, you'll
see it switches back again. So what I've got, this effect is really useful now, is that I've got, first of all, it working as a cursor usual, and then of course I've got it doing this highlight, which is great because it shows the text underneath really clearly. I love that. Really, really useful. You can actually increase as well. If we just click on there, you do have the option of increasing the size of the magnifier, and you have to be very careful when you do this, but you can, if you want to, just make it a little bit bigger, okay, if you want to do that. Okay, really lovely idea, the Magnify tool, and it works really well when you are scrolling over small text, or exactly what I've done there, menu items. Now, if you want to know more about editing in Camtasia, I've got a very popular video on YouTube that you might want to watch, and I've put it on the screen now. You can click on it and go to that particular video. But let's carry on with more things around Camtasia. We're going to actually look now at some of the things you can do in Camtasia 2022, some of the new features. Remember, you've got your properties here for your cursor, okay? And anytime you select any of the objects on the screen or on the timeline, then it will show you the properties of that particular object or that particular piece of video. And of course, you'll see that the cursor one's there. Now, one thing that we can do then is delete all of that. And I'm actually going to delete all of that lovely work I've done. Okay, so I'm going to click on this one as well, come to cursor, I'm going to delete that because I want to show you some other options as well. Okay, so again, just click it on here and delete those properties. Okay, now don't forget, we've actually got three videos now rather than one video, but that's okay for what I want to demonstrate. This is another really useful option that you've now got available to you. This has really been brought in because of Camtasia 2022. You can increase the size of the cursor itself. So if I just click here, and let's choose this one here, I can increase the size. Now, this is what we call a vector graphic, and vector graphics will actually increase in size and still look really good in terms of the quality. So you do have that control, which is something you never had before. Now, often that's quite useful because even if we look at, for example, this here, you notice that the cursor is quite small. So you might say to yourself, right, I want generally that cursor to be a little bit bigger on the screen, and you can increase the size of it if you want to, just to make the cursor a bit bigger and a bit clearer. That particularly happens when you've got a busy screen, lots of things going on, and you just want to make sure that the cursor is clearer so that everyone can see it. Just a super quick break from the video. If you are looking for more free videos, particularly on Camtasia, come over to teachertrainingvideos.com, click on the section on screen capture, and you'll see there's a number of videos there. If you want me to do some training with you, then please contact me from my website. As I said, I am a trainer, recommended trainer in using Camtasia from TechSmith. The other thing is, if you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you'll get updated with all the blog posts, the new videos, the online courses that I run. And I often run free webinars on the topic of Camtasia as well. The other thing is that you might want to join me, of course, on my YouTube channel, and you can do that from the top there on the right hand side. Right, let's get back to the video. Now, of all the updates in 2022, I think this is my favorite Camtasia update. It's something definitely, well, in fact, I've already used it a couple of times. And I'm just going to demonstrate when it can be useful. When it's really useful is when you want to add a cursor effect to an image. So we've got here, for example, my picture here of my website, but there's nothing happening because it's just an image. And maybe what I actually want is a cursor moving around, and therefore I might add some narration afterwards to explain what's happening. Now, I can actually do that now. If I come over to cursor effects, you've got something called a cursor path creator. And if you just drag that onto the screen and drop it on, immediately it actually creates a cursor effect for you. Now, one of the interesting things, if I play that straight away, I've now got the cursor moving along. However, of course, I can edit this and I can do many of the things that I couldn't do before, which I can now do in Camtasia. For example, if I wanted to make that a little bit bigger, I could definitely do that. We've got the cursor path here already set out, but we are able to completely edit that path. So for example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the starting point here. I'm going to set the end point here. But actually, what I want it to do as well is en route, I want it to visit where you can sign up to my YouTube channel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click over the actual cursor path, and I'm going to click on add cursor point, and I'm going to drag a cursor point in there. Okay, now I also want it to talk about the adverts here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to add another cursor point, so about here. So I'm going to right click again, add a cursor point, and at that point I'm going to drag it over to here. So it's now going on quite a long journey. Now, I'm not only restricted in that, if we just come down here and kind of make this a little bit longer, we can actually click on that cursor path and drag it out and extend where the things happen. So for example, I might want to do it like this. Let me just see if I can just do that so that it's nicely evened out. So we got our first 4 points, but we got the cursor now moving fairly quickly from the start. If I click on it, hopefully you'll see the effect. There it goes, and there, and there, and there. And of course, I can play around with this as much as I want. So for example, I could really extend that out, okay, and bring that one perhaps to here, etc. So I've got loads of options in terms of working, and where this is going to be so useful is when I'm working with basically with an image that I want to add onto the screen, or anytime I've got some video content where I haven't got a cursor but I actually feel I need one. Now, if you're interested in some of the other things that you can add into your videos, not just the cursor, but for example, arrows and the drawing tool and the focus tool, etc., there is a video on the screen now that takes you through some of the additional things that you can do on the timeline to add to the videos. But if you stay on this video, what I'm going to do now is show you some more tricks with cursors. So let's quickly play that cursor path and just see how it's looking. So I'm just going to click here. Really good. All I would need to do now is add voice narration. Now, just one little thing to remember as well. When you're working with images, you can easily expand how long they stay on the timeline, and of course therefore you can drag out how long the animation takes. So you've actually got a lot of control over the way that the cursor will move around on the screen, how long it will take, etc. Now, as I said, I've only done a couple of these so far, but I must say really useful effects, and of course lots and lots of options. You know, you can again come back to using either a magnifying or a cursor spotlight, which we've not even looked at. Let's have a quick look at this cursor spotlight as a final thing to show you. So one thing is, when we're working here, you can see that we've got the cursor on the screen now. I'm going to just add it on as a spotlight. So I'm going to drop that on just so that you see that effect as well. Let's play it now. That's not an effect that I use that often, but it's still a useful one at certain points. It can be, again, really good if you're trying to pull the attention to certain parts of the screen. There's actually lots of things you can do in Camtasia to make videos look more professional, and I've got a video from YouTube that goes through how to make videos more professional with interesting intros and outros and that sort of thing. If you want to learn about that, I'm putting that video on the screen now, but if you want to learn more about cursors, we're going to carry on with some more things that you can do. One final cursor option that I do want to point out, this isn't actually new to 2022, it's been around for a while now. Again, if you come down to your cursor effects, and often this happens to me, I move too quickly on the screen, I'm moving everything around at 100 mile an hour, and it looks a bit jaunty, a bit jumpy, You can see it a little bit on here, for example, if I just play this and I'm suddenly kind of moving around like that. What I can do is I can simply make sure you've got the video selected. I can just bring on cursor smoothing. Cursor smoothing also will kind of take away any of those things where you're going around in circles. It will kind of make it nice and straight. It depends how bad the original recording is, how good the cursor smoothing works. It's a good idea to put the highlight tool on. You can often see it better there. Let's just play a little bit of it.
You will see here on the front page all of the courses that I'm currently offering, and also if you click over here to the right hand side.
Okay, you saw it working a little bit there as I moved from this part to this part. It did it nicely, nice and smooth.
You'll see that there's the newsletter which you can click on and join. Third thing to know about is that,
and again, that's doing that nice and smoothly. Okay, it's smoothing as I scroll down, so that's also a nice effect to keep in mind. Okay, I really hoped you liked that video, and as I said, come over to teachertrainingvideos.com, click on the section on screen capture. There's a number of videos there that you can access immediately on working with Camtasia. As I've said, I am a recommended TechSmith trainer in Camtasia, and if you want, you can contact me. But also, if you sign up to the newsletter, you'll get updated when I release new videos on Camtasia, but also the webinars that I often run that are sponsored by TechSmith Camtasia, and I take people through the technology, and those are often free. The other thing you can do, of course, is to sign up to my YouTube channel. I'm going to leave a few videos now on the screen that you might find interesting. They're all about Camtasia, and they focus on other features of Camtasia that you might like to learn about.